For the AMD cut, you want to make sure you know how to do a revolution cut and also a swing cut, and I'll put the links to those in the description as always. Now to start, you hold the deck in a biddle grip and you place your right ring finger to the corner of this card over here, like so, and you come over with your left hand, and with this part of your thumb you will strip off about a fifth of the deck. It needs to be fairly thick in comparison to normal tornado cut packets, so you can break it later more easily. So you just break it off, and it's really high on this part of your thumb. So break this one off and rotate it 180 degrees with your left ring finger, like so. Next, you will break off a fairly small packet with your right index finger, like so, and swing cut into your left hand, like so. So just do a swing cut and take it over with your thumb and your index finger from your left hand. After that, and this packet is still held between your right ring finger and this part of your thumb, you will pull out the packet held by your right hand, like so. And because this packet is underneath the other one, by pulling this packet to yourself and by pushing down with this packet with your thumb, the packet will automatically rotate like so. So again, biddle grip, riffle off a little bit bigger packet, rotate it with your ring finger. Swing cut a small packet into your hand, pull out to the back and rotate it with the corner of this packet, like so. You will now take this packet over between your left index finger and your right thumb, so like this, and you will re-grip the small packet in your palm to a Cardini grip, like so. You will then extend this Cardini grip packet, like so, and change the grip from your index finger to your thumb, like this. After that, rotate the big packet held in your right hand underneath this packet and place the big packet into your palm and close the Cardini cut and take this packet over between your thumb and middle finger and ring finger on your right hand. Again, riffle off, rotate, swing cut a small packet, turn it over, take it over between thumb and index, Cardini grip, extend, move to the front, switch to your thumb, rotate it underneath, drop in your hand, close the packet, take it over. And after that, you will split the big packet held between your two thumbs with your right index finger, like so. So you just split this packet and you will rotate the two held by your right hand to the top, like so. You will then transfer the whole thing to your pinky finger, so from your thumb moves down to your pinky finger, like that. This is similar to the grip from On the Moon, and you will then, from this grip, rotate the hand forward and swivel off the topmost packet with your left index finger. So your left index finger comes over and the packet is held by your two index fingers, and you will swivel this into your hand like so. And now you have one packet held between your in a one-handed grip. And this packet is held between your thumb and pinky and a biddle grip over here. Now two things happen simultaneously. For one, you will take this packet over between your index and pinky, so kind of a straddle grip, but with two fingers. You will lift it and rotate it a bit to take it over, so the corner of the card shows to your thumb and to your middle finger, so you can take it over in a corner grip. basically from here, just pinky and index finger, clip it, lift it up, rotate it a bit, thumb shows, corner shows to thumb, and middle finger also on the corner, and you take it over. And now you will do revolution cut in your left hand while you rotate this packet 360 degrees, like that. Basically in your left hand, all that happens is this motion, in your right hand I mean, all that happens is this, with another packet over here, so you can keep a small gap, like so. So the rotation is easier, because if they touch each other it's getting a bit harder to do smooth rotations. And in your left hand, which is kind of difficult in the beginning, we'll do revolution cut without your pinky finger, because your pinky finger needs to be straight up and holding this packet. So practice this maybe separately if you have troubles with that, just doing revolution cuts without your pinky. But basically lift it off, extend, rotate it underneath, take it over, split this packet, index, rotate it on top, rotate it to your pinky, swivel it to your index and into the hand, regrip, revolution and rotation at the same time. And after you did that, you will take this packet over to your thumb again from your pinky, like so, and you will regrip this packet into modified Cardini grip, but this time you will curl in your index, your middle finger instead of your ring finger, so your pinky is free and you can still extend this packet in a Cardini grip. So basically just re-grip it to your thumb and extend, and while you do that you will do another rotation with your index finger. And if you've done this rotation, you will just push through with your index finger, like that. After that, change it back from your thumb to your pinky finger, like so, and just bring it into your palm, like that. Close the Cardini grip, display this packet, and after you're done, you just bring it back in and close, similar to molecule 3. So the ending again. One rotation with the revolution cut, grip to your thumb, extend, another rotation to your pinky finger and into your hand, close the Cardini grip and show the packet. And if you're doing it fast, you can also skip the last part with the pinky finger, because you don't need it if you just drop it instantly into your hand, like that, kind of. But the safer way is to your pinky finger. So once again, riffle off with the part of your thumb, rotate it with your index, with your ring finger, like so. Split off a small packet with your index finger, swing cut into the left hand, pull this packet out, rotate it with the corner, take it over between index and thumb, Cardini grip, extend, take it over with the thumb from the index, rotate this underneath, bring back the Cardini packet, take it over, split this packet with your index, held by two thumbs, rotate it outward, change from your thumb to your pinky, swivel it with your index into your hand, regrip, revolution cut and rotation at the same time, regrip to thumb, keep rotating, extend into your hand, and close. And as always with the cuts from Kent, you should really try to bring in movement into the cut, so it looks better than just standing there and rotating it. Especially the last part can be quite intense if you make it look right, which you learn after a lot of practice. So I'm still not happy with mine, so just experiment with the movements and try to really just try to bring life into the cut. And yeah, this cut is also a false cut, so remember that, and that's basically it.